There is something that many people forget when they are choosing which business to do, and that is cash flow. Many people look at profit. They say, if I put in this money, I can get this. But they forget about cash flow. Cash flow means how money comes in, how often money comes in, and how it goes out. A business where you're, let's say, selling cars, and you sell one car a month, or maybe one car in 2 months, has a bad cash flow. Even when it may have a lot of profit, you might find that maybe on that car, you are earning 10 million shillings profit, but it has a bad cash flow. Remember, throughout that month, you are going to be spending every day. You'll spend on transport, you'll spend on food, you'll spend on medication, and so on. There are many costs that every business meets. You have to clean, and so on. You have to pay utility bills, rent. So you meet daily costs. That is why a good business to start with, for a starter who has little capital, you need to consider one that has a cash flow. In other words, money comes in regularly. I run a restaurant, Obunuzi restaurant, Wandegea. It does not matter how much money we start with in the morning. You'll find people will come and buy sodas, another one will buy water, one will buy a chapati, another one will buy food, lasagna, another one will buy a pizza. So when there are small costs of cleaning, buying stationery, utility bills, and so on, you'll find you're able to meet them. Even before you think about profit. Profit comes later. In fact, a business can survive for even a year or more without profit, but relying on cash flow. Remember, there is what we call supplier's credit. When you're credible in a business, you're established, you keep your word, you're going to get people that will supply to you, and they get their payment later. You'll find a cleaner who will clean for you and expect the payment at the end of the month, even when they are giving a service daily. You'll find a supplier of stock or whatever you're using, who will be able to give you about 30 days, or even if it is a week. Meaning you can utilize the cash flow. Money comes in, you clear what you used yesterday, and so on until you make a profit. You keep working around the costs, minimizing the costs, adjusting, increasing sales, marketing better, adjusting products, adjusting prices, until you can make a profit. Once you have a good cash flow, you're likely to make it in business. Once the cash flow is bad, my friend, you'll die of pressure. You'll die of heart attack. When a landlord comes and puts a chain on your door, it does not matter whether the money is coming next week. He can close you down. So when you're choosing a business, this is something you should not forget, especially when it is the first business. If it is not a first business, or if you have a lot of capital, then this may not apply so much, because you might be having other sources of income that will maintain the costs until you make a profit. But if it is the first business and it is what you're looking at to meet the costs, please, make sure you start with a business that has a good cash flow, which brings in money every day or every week. This is Robert Bakke, Mr. Inspiration. Greetings from World of Inspiration. We thank you for supporting World of Inspiration Group. We have World of Inspiration Publications, which publishes and sells inspirational books. We have World of Inspiration Travels for dealing in cars. Obunuzi restaurant in Wandegea, opposite YMCA gate. That is at Moil petrol station between YMCA and Wandegea police. Win-win microfinance, and of course win-win properties for dealing in land and houses. If you need a plot of land, if you need an acre of land, if you need a house, World of Inspiration Group is here to serve you.